What's going on, guys? This is back on the 91 Pontiac Firebird. Right now I've got the negative terminal off the battery disconnected completely, and the reason why is if you step over here, I am going to be doing some electrical work. And of course, like always, having to redo somebody else's electrical stuff for their stereo. I went down and bought a JVC KDT, 900 BTS for this car. And I've been needing to do this for a while anyway. But if you take a look down here, what's going on with the wiring, I've already got this already fixed up. But why don't you solder this? I'm going to run into all this real quick for y'all. You got a splice. Of course, he has more splices. Wrong. It should not be like this. If you're going to do splice, you need to do it one splice only. Or, the smart thing to do is if the plug is still attached to the original harness, do not cut the plug. Find a adapter that will plug into that, that will plug into your, or that will splice into your your radio harness, and then plug into your radio. That would have been the correct way to do it, but the guy, fiance or wife's dad, whichever, came in here, cut the plug, and just twist the wires, put electrical tape on it, called it a day, and then put in some butt connectors. Now, this here would be the correct way of putting, if he's going to splice in, that's fine. That's perfectly fine, but back here is not. He should have just went ahead and ran it all one single wire all the way to the harness, not having a bunch of splices. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through and I'm going to put in butt connectors. And I've got a female here. And I've got some males here. I was actually going to see about trying to solder my harness off the stereo. I was actually going to solder in. But the only problem with this is if I ever change the radio, or say sometime down the line, which I don't see that's happening, but you know, for whatever reason, because things do come up, say if the car ever gets sold, somebody puts a different radio in, now they'll have to come back and they'll have to cut the harness and they'll have to splice. And the more you splice this harness, the shorter it's going to get, and eventually you're not going to have nothing. So with me doing it this way, with the butt connectors with female and male plug, all they have to do, or all I have to do if I ever change the radio in this, is unplug it, boom. And then once I get a new harness, new radio, all I have to do is put a new male in on my harness and plop, plug it in. That's all I got to do. It's a lot easier and a lot simpler. That way I'm not hacking more of my the original harness and stuff up. It's a lot easier that way. Now, granted, that these here, these type of butt connectors, they are heat shrink style. I love these things. They keep out moisture, you know, for better protection of your wire. I did buy some heat shrink, of course, because, like I said, I was thinking about going ahead and doing the solder, but I changed my mind on it. So what I may end up doing is taking, you know, what I may do is after I heat shrink this down and get everything plugged in, I may go ahead and put some more heat shrink over the butt connector. I'm sure it's probably not necessary, but you know, maybe for a little bit cleaner look. But then again, I may just leave it as is and just use the heat shrink of that. So we'll see how it turns out. The plus side is to figure out what your color code is off your harness that goes to the radio. is there is the wiring diagram for where each wire goes. Now, all harnesses, car harnesses, are not the same. Some of them are. Sometimes you can just know, you know exactly where it goes and everything plugs in nice. If your plug is completely disconnected, if your plug is completely cut off like mine and you just have these wires, you will have to take a test light and figure out which is hot, which I already know this is hot because off the other plug right here, this was the battery. And as you can see, there is a little deal that says battery. All right, now this one had a little fuse on it. I was actually gonna fix this on the other end, but I could not find the right size gauge wire nor the right fuse. Some of them don't have to have a fuse. Some of them calls for a fuse. This particular harness did not call for a fuse, or it would have came with one, but I don't see one. You can put an inline fuse in it if you can get the right gauge wire, but never put a inline fuse with a bigger wire, like a, what was it, a 30 gauge? I don't remember, but there's a, or I can't remember exactly, 8 gauge, 12 gauge, or something, I don't know, I don't remember, but anyway, usually the harness, or the fuse wire from AutoZone is a lot bigger. I don't trust that. Try to use the same gauge wire all the way through and through. You're better off. So, I already know that this is my hot wire, and that will go here, but it will have, like I said, it will have a mail end on it. And what I also like to do is when I stick the wire and stuff in, get it spliced back and get pushed it through the terminal here, I like to actually push and twist so that way it's in there pretty tight, and then crimp it. And then after you get it crimped, just give it a nice little tug, make sure it's not going to come off. Same with the other one, and that one is ready to be put in. And this is what it should look like. Come on, clear up. But anyway, this should what it should look like after you put the heat and stuff on it. Get the heat shrink. Okay, fits in there pretty tight, so ain't gonna be no moisture or anything getting down in there, so that's a plus. So that one's done. All I gotta do is do that one next. And as you see, that one's done as well. And also, I just kind of want to show y'all real quick, where these other wires that's probably not going to be used at all whatsoever, I am going to take all the electrical tape off of these wires, like this one here, this gray one, if it don't go to anything. If it does, then good, but if not, I'm going to just take the electrical tape off, and I'm going to use some heat shrink on the ends of those, so that way it don't touch nothing, you know. So that's what's going to be in the process. And I went ahead and pulled this wire loose. This is a ground wire, so it's already, I've already pulled it loose from the other plug and got it wrapped around to where I can actually get to it. Now, like I said, when I put these wires together and stuff, they're going to be a lot neater, they're going to be a lot cleaner than what you see here. That's just horrible. That's just completely horrible. So I'm gonna fix this up real quick. And it looks like the wire here, it looks like it's in pretty good condition. I may trim it back just a little bit off the wire here and give a little bit more cleaner deal. So it's not as long. I wanna shorten it just a little bit, but as far as the copper of it, it looks really good, looks clean, so I'm gonna reuse it. All right, so now I've got my ground wire fixed up, and I've got this ground wire fixed up. I'm kind of going through the harness for y'all, so that way if y'all do end up doing this too for y'all's Camaro or Firebird for the 92 through 82, if y'all have the same color harness that I have, as far as the factory goes, then y'all know which way it goes. I am actually, like I said, I'm really glad that he left the stickers and stuff on, so that way I know where they all go. So that way this also helps y'all, because sometimes I know some people likes cutting the plugs off, and I've seen a lot of stuff where it don't even have the little tabs to let you know where they all go. So I know this is probably going to help y'all out tremendously. And I don't know why my phone keeps blaring on me. I have no clue. I'm trying to do my best to show y'all all this and walk all this through to you guys. And what I'm going to also do when I get them done one at a time, I'm going to go ahead and plug them in. See, like I did that one. This is what I was talking about. If you ever had to, like I said, if you ever had to replace a radio, you know, if you used to do this method, or somebody, or like, or if you've got the car for me or whatever, and you had to do this method, all you would have to do, you wouldn't have to cut nothing. You wouldn't have to cut nothing at all. All you'd have to do is watch this. All you'd have to do is just pull the, hang on a second. All you'd have to do is just pull it apart. So all you had to do is pull it apart. And then on your new harness that you get, just put a terminal like this on it, and then stick it back in. You know, and then that way, see, like I said, it makes your life a lot easier. All right, so off the old harness here, I'm gonna find the accessory wire, which is right there. There's the accessory wire, it's red. In our cars, it's gonna be a yellow wire. And there's the red wire off of my new plug. And I'm gonna do it the exact same way, then we'll take this tape off. I noticed something with this accessory wire right here. I took the tape and stuff off. They did put heat shrink back here. When I pulled the heat shrink back, you can see that there's a little nick in the wire. So I can do this one or two ways. I can reheat shrink that, or in my case, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna cut this plug back, you know, right here where that's at. And I'm gonna just splice it right there. There's enough wire I can play with. So, the less shorts I have to deal with, the better. All right, guys, I'm gonna call this I'm gonna call this quits for right now. I'm gonna go in here, recharge my battery for this phone. But you can see what I'm doing here and everything. I'm gonna come back with a part two, and I'm gonna finish this up for you. All right, later guys, I'll see y'all in the next video.